In this video, I'm going to show you how to make use of HTML forms with JSP. And we'll actually cover the following topics. I'll first start off with a review of HTML forms. Then I'll show you how to build an HTML form. Next, we'll learn how to read the form data with JSP. All right, a lot of good stuff. We've all used HTML forms before. If you've gone to any website where you had to log in with the user ID and password, that information was entered via an HTML form. Also, if you've gone to any travel site and booked an airline trip or a hotel reservation, again, all of that data was entered through an HTML form. All right, so what we're going to do here is we're going to learn how to build an HTML form to read student information. We're going to prompt the student for their first name and last name. They'll enter it into a text field, and then once they enter that data, they'll hit the submit button. Once they hit submit, that data will be sent over to a JSP page for processing. So we'll have a JSP page, we'll read the form data for the first name and the last name, and we'll send back a confirmation page to the browser. And I'll show you how to put all of this together. We'll start with the form first, and then we'll move into the actual JSP development. All right, let's get started. So here's the coding here for the HTML form. So again, we want to have an HTML form for the first name and last name, along with the submit button. So when you build an HTML form, you start off with the form tag, and then you specify the action. You're basically telling the system where to send the form data. So we're telling the system here, send the form data to studentresponse.jsp. Next, we set up our text fields for first name and last name. So for text field, we have input type equals text. We give name equals first name. And that name's very important. We'll need that name on the server side. We do a similar thing here for last name. Input type equals text, name equals last name. And then finally, for our submit button, we set up an input type. So we say input type equals submit, and then we give the value of submit. So the value portion here is really just the label that you'll see on the submit button. But once they hit the submit button, then that data will actually be sent over to the appropriate JSP page for processing. All right, so now here's the coding here for reading the form data. So whenever we read the form data with the JSP, it's very important that we need to know the names of those HTML form fields. So I have these HTML form fields here on this slide just for reference. So at the bottom in the JSP file, we simply want to say the student is confirmed, and we want to display the student's first name and last name. So we read the form data by saying request.getParameter, and we give that form field name, first name. And then to read the last name, I do a similar thing, request.getParameter, last name. And we place all that inside of a JSP expression with the angle bracket percent with the equal symbol. And that will allow us to read the form data in JSP. Next, here's an alternate syntax for reading the form data. So you can make use of this dollar sign curly brace, and then you can say param.formFieldName. So a simpler way of writing this page is the student is confirmed, and then we simply say dollar sign curly brace param dot first name. And a similar thing here, dollar sign curly brace param dot last name. So this is really just a shortcut method. It's only used for displaying form data. So it's really just a shorthand, simpler way of writing the code. But if you needed to read the form data in like maybe a scriptlet or something, then you'd have to resort back to using the request.getParameter. But as much as possible, I'll try and make use of the shortcut method in our confirmation pages. All right, so this wraps up this portion of the video. In the following video, I'll actually do a code demo, and I'll take you to Eclipse, and we'll actually write the code in Eclipse. So I'll see you in the next video.